Gonzo and Pepe the King Prawn are headed off to a special Halloween party. Not the special Halloween party the Muppets are throwing, mind you. This is a different one. Instead, Gonzo is choosing to take up the challenge of his mentor, the Great MacGuffin. Spend a night in the most haunted place on Earth and face your fears to become the greatest Death Defier of all time. However, should Gonzo and Pepe fail to exit the mansion before sunrise, they will become trapped within its walls forever, and the dwellers in this haunted mansion are always welcoming more guests each day. This is the Muppets Haunted Mansion. So yeah, this is a special on Disney Plus. It is very short. I'll get to my problems with the length a little bit later on. But overall, it's really fun. It's a great Muppet special. Like I said, there's a little bit of the other Muppets in here. Obviously, they play other roles. They play some of the ghosts that pop up. Kermit the Frog is like, presents, I think it was like the Mansion Show as opposed to the Muppet Show. So you have him acting like the old Muppet Show, Kermit the Frog, you know, being the MC, the Master of Ceremonies. Fozzie is a Jekyll and Hyde ghost comedian bear, who of course gets heckled by ghosts Statler and Waldorf. Miss Piggy is a spirit of the crystal ball who portends future events and things like that. So yeah, like I said, you get the other Muppets kind of sprinkled without, and you get to see them in their normal forms too. As like I said, they're throwing a Halloween costume party, and Piggy has suggested that she and Kermit gender swap, basically. So she's dressed as Kermit, and Kermit is dressed as Piggy. And so you get the very weird affect of Kermit trying to talk like Miss Piggy, and Piggy trying to talk like Kermit with the Piggy nails like the actions of Kermit, but you know she's still very self-serving in many ways. So again, that adds to a little bit of humor in there. They're not, you know, I mean, I hesitate to call them the proper Muppets, but as opposed to the ghost Muppets, but yeah, the proper Muppets. They definitely, they do a little bit here and there, but yeah, it's definitely the ghosts that play throughout this. As Gonzo and Pepe arrive, you know, they meet a gravekeeper who basically says, hey, you know, again, kind of gives them the rules of the challenge and everything. Then they meet the butler of the mansion, who's played by Will Arnett. You know, there's a couple other appearances through there. And, you know, as they're going through the mansion, Gonzo, who pretends to be fearless and has never says he doesn't have to worry about facing his fears because he's not afraid of anything, basically kind of just enjoys everything seeing there, while Pepe is constantly being thrown around. Like, he thought he was going to a Hollywood celebrity Halloween party, and he's looking around for famous people. Very briefly, he bumps into John Stamos, and that winds up kind of terrifying. That goes into a funny area. I won't get too detailed into that. There's also kind of a running joke where people are speaking Spanish with Pepe, only to then reveal that they don't actually know any Spanish. And eventually Pepe winds up running into the ghost of the bride, who's played by Taraji P. Henson. And of course the joke is that the bride marries these men and kills them instantly. So, you know, when Gonzo starts to realize things are going wrong, he has to save Pepe. I won't get too... hopefully I'm not getting too spoilery at this point, but there is one point, though, where we see a rapidly aging Gonzo, and that actually does kind of qualify as terrifying, as you're about to see. Okay, so, yeah. Anyway. Like I said, if I had one real problem with it, I think it's too short. This thing is... this is 52 minutes, but that's with about 2.5 minutes of credits tacked onto it. So yeah, it's really more like 49 minutes. So yeah, and that's where it's not bad. It's just if you make this an hour, you know, to maybe an hour and 10 minutes, I think it's a much better show. You could maybe add some more gags on this, because I think the other problem too is there's a lot of times we're focusing strictly on Pepe and not enough on Gonzo, even though Gonzo is supposed to be the central character in this. And that's the thing against Pepe. I think he's well utilized in this, but not as well as he was utilized in Muppets Now, but still pretty well utilized. But yeah, this one just kind of there were some parts I felt just a little lacking. It's like I wish they had maybe stretched out a little bit more. I wish there were maybe some more sight gags with Gonzo involved as well. But yeah, Other than that, it's not bad. It's still very enjoyable. I'm going to be giving Muppets Haunted Mansion an A. Like I said, watch this. It'll have fun. Make this a Halloween tradition, especially because, you know, Muppets need more representation on Disney Plus, and we should be supporting that whenever it happens. And this is the perfect way to do it. In fact, maybe we could do other things with the Muppets in Disney rides. Like, I don't know if you could do Muppets Pirates of the Caribbean, but maybe you could do something like... I'm trying to think now. Disney rides with the Muppets. You know, Muppets, you know, Frozen Maelstrom or something like that. Like, do something else where, yeah, Muppets Pirates of the Caribbean might not be the best one. But yeah, definitely do something like that. Maybe even adapt Muppet Vision 3D into its own thing, where it's like the Muppets are trying to put on the show to see if they're worthy of staying in the park. That could be something fun. Like, so yeah, like I said, it's an A. Make it a yearly tradition. I think it'll be really fun, especially for the youngins.
They're coming. They're coming to your town. Wait till you tell the kids. The all-new Muppet Babies Live with special guest stars Miss Piggy. And Kermit.
Hello, everybody. Hi there.
The Muppet Babies Live on stage. Wait till you tell the kids.
Wednesday through Sunday, San Jose Civic Auditorium. Good seats still available at Bass and Ticketmaster Centers.
Okay, so the next video is going to be the Halloween Kills recap and review. After that, it's going to be the Dune recap and review, and then the Random Trade review on The Vision and the Scarlet Witch. With that last one, there's a bit more to it than that. My collection includes the Giant Size Avengers issue where they get married. I'm not really going to be including that as part of the story recap, though, because of reasons I'll get to in that episode. But yeah, if you know anything about the issue where they get married and the grander narrative it's part of, yeah, you would probably understand why. Other than that, yeah, I swear at some point I'll get that other Madden video done. It's just time has not been of the essence in the last few weeks. See you all next time.
Hey guys, remember, you can help support my channel at patreon.com/sleepytimeforcatproductions, where you can help request a movie, even if it's something like, say, Sonic the Hedgehog or the next Purge film. I'll review it.